Is that record, Otto up there?
Record.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
Yeah, I think that's Otto.
How are you? How are you doing?
I hope
are
my
you
phone.
On video?
I think I got. I tried, but then it all of a sudden went off. I'll let you know when we're back.
Yay!
So, welcome to the pre-show.
And thank
it's
you.
Nice to have all of you here. We have a big room.
Yeah,
we have quite a few people here tonight. Yeah. So, first timers to, to the pre-show. Wow, most of you. Well, what we do here for the first timers is I allow you to ask any question within reason. Ask any question. I do this because I want people to see a different side of me, because you all see the entertainer. And even if I show you some pictures of my family or my grandkids, all I ask is you don't post them, okay?
No,
so,
don't.
Those are the rules.
Yeah.
And if you do, I have to slap you so much.
She's going to post now.
Good way. Yes, please.
How are you doing?
Good.
Right.
What's your name?
Jay Van Abelow.
Jay, nice to see you. That's my brother's name. It's Jay.
Yep.
Yeah.
So it's good to have you here. We have one, two, three guys. Yeah, that's one, two, three. Yes.
You should be used to that.
What's your name?
Are you talking to me?
Yep.
I'm Jeannie Jaco, and this is my husband, Bob.
Hello, Bob.
Hi. Hi.
Hello.
How are you, Bob?
Great.
I call him Burford. But anyway, I need to do a video if I can, because I got a message for you from Tom Roach.
Yes.
You know him?
Yes.
He's my friend, too.
Oh, yeah.
And he wants to know if you listen to him on WNBR radio?
WBNR.
BNR.
I don't really listen that much, but yes, I've tuned in and
okay.
The show, yeah.
Well,
last night, I tuned it up for a few minutes, yeah.
He is promoting your new album. He's working really hard.
Oh, that's, tell him thank you.
Yeah, I will do that. And like I said, he calls Bob Burford all the time. Does he look like a Burford? But I love him very much. We've been married 38 years.
38 years.
Yeah.
This is their anniversary weekend.
Yeah,
Yep.
And I wanted to say hi from Michelle Travis and from my sis in the UK. And they're all wanting to know, are you coming back to the UK?
As soon as I can.
I know.
They're keeping me
you
so
all
busy
love it,
here. I was thinking about a long time ago, last year, of doing a UK tour this summer over in the UK. But my break was taken in December. I went over there and did a show called Pantoland.
I saw some of that.
And I promised Debbie and my grandkids, that I would take the summer off.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good for you.
Good.
So, for those of you who haven't seen the show, it's a lot of work, you know, and I just need the summer off.
Yeah. Amen.
Yeah.
And Donnie, your friend Linda Ann Sosa. She is in the hospital. She's in Rose Hospital here. And she might have to have a pacemaker.
Okay.
And it would make her so happy if you say hello to her on this video.
Oh, you're recording?
I am.
They better be filming there.
It's okay. My dad had a pacemaker for so many years.
Oh,
it's okay.
Wow.
It happens all the time. Oh. I may have to get one of these.
You've got so much rhythm, I don't worry about that at all.
Linda, we don't mean to make light of the situation.
Mm-hmm.
No, it's very serious. So,
yeah.
You hang in there, baby, okay?
She loves you very much.
Y'all. Thank you.
We all do.
Stay healthy, Linda. Any other questions? Yes. Oh, I got to hear this Tommy Osborne story. What is your name?
Marnie. When I was 5 years old, I came to the Tropicana Hotel.
Oh, I remember you. I remember seeing you in the front row there.
No.
You should remember me.
Why?
Oh, my God.
What did you do?
Oh, I was just so enthralled. Oh, my gosh. Anyways, you came over and bent down and you sang to me.
Aww.
And you gave me a kiss on the cheek.
Aww.
I was 5 years old, and I remember to this day you're sweating.
This was a great moment to say this. You were sweating. Marnie, do you remember the song?
I have a replica of my hat.
Oh no.
I have a replica.
Do you remember the song I sent to you?
It was Puppy Love.
Okay, do me a favor.
Which one?
Bring up
Puppy Love.
Puppy Love for a second.
No, oh, is he?
40-some-odd years? Okay, here we go. This is like 40 years. What? And, like, stop. Make sure it's recording.
What is she doing?
Okay. Here we go.
No,
go ahead.
Wait. Give other people a
chance. And they called it Poppy Love.
Oh, my gosh.
Woo! Oh, I guess I'll never know how a young heart really feels and why I love her so.
Donnie. Hi, I'm Heather. I'm from Texas. I don't know if you've received it yet. I am a fifth grade elementary school teacher for J.C. Austin Elementary.
That's cool. Thank you.
33 of my kiddos actually wrote you fan mail. My dad passed away.
What grade?
Fifth.
Fifth grade. Okay. And your dad?
Yes. My dad passed away January 31st.
Oh, I'm sorry.
2 days after my birthday. Oh. He waited. Wow. Thank you. this beautiful lady to my left is my mom.
Hi, Mom.
Hi.
39
Hi.
Years ago, she sang Until the 12th of Never to my dad on their wedding day.
Oh.
And it would change my life and her life. And if you could please even just sing a word of that song.
Let's do 12.
Will you dedicate it to Larry Colvin for me?
Larry Colvin?
Yes, sir.
Okay. This is dedicated to the great Larry Colvin.
Oh, my God.
Thank you.
Birthday,
we had to come and see you, so we
wanted to.
Both of
you? Happy
birthday!
Are you serious?
We're Megan's.
You look like you're 30.
Wow. So do you.
What are your names?
Lynette and Lori. We're Megan Casteller's friends. Megan, I
don't know. Oh, Megan, yeah. Megan's friends. She
yeah.
told you were going to be here.
Yeah, that's us.
Okay, so Lynette. Thank
you very much. I'm Lynette.
How do you spell Lynette?
L-Y-N-E-T-T-E.
L-Y-N-E-T-T-E.
Any way you want to spell it.
Yeah. And yours is?
Lori.
L-O-R.
Just a name to go with hers.
L-O-R-I?
Yeah.
And it's your 60th.
We're 5 minutes apart.
Yep. No
way.
Who's
the name? Lynette
and Lori. Lynette and Lori. Will you say that?
Yeah, let's give this a shot.
Lynette and Lori, it's your birthday. Have a celebrate, sing a song. Another year is true, but 60 years. for me.
Wonderful. Oh, my gosh.
Yes.
Wonderful.
What is your name?
Ida.
Ida.
But I just want to say, so I'm a recent fan. She's a super fan of hers. She came to concert today and by herself, and she came today as well. But I want to say, just really thank you for being so brave to share. I listened to one of your interviews with Drew Raymore recently.
Yes.
And you shared about how you went through some dark times and about the importance of people who help you through dark times. And I just want to say, my mom was one of those people who still helped me through dark times. And she has taught me to be
yeah. How strong. So I would be honored
if you could sing
one of the
favorite songs, which is
Just the Way You Are.
Oh,
is it just
the
way you are?
Oh, the way you are.
And she flew all the way from Hong Kong for this. She got
no
the
way.
Wow,
yeah.
That's awesome.
Wonderful. And she got off the plane, she ran to come to this show.
Where do you live, Ida?
In Toronto.
I used to live in
Yes,
Eglinton and is it Mount Pleasant? Yeah.
I think I did leave that.
Yes. But thank you for bringing that up. The mental health is something that is so serious these days.
Yes.
Back in '97, I came up with an autobiography talking about the fact that I suffered with anxiety and all this kind of stuff, and I was very worried about disclosing all that because it really wasn't in vogue, so to speak. It wasn't really looked upon with a positive outlook. I'm glad I did. There was an experience. Cindy, you may have heard me tell this experience, but you probably haven't heard about this. But I did suffer from anxiety. I couldn't even go on stage. The same lady that got me on stage is the one that got Barbara Streisand on stage. I mean, I could say these names because they've disclosed the fact. Her name is Geraldyn Ross, the late Geraldyn Ross. And I won't go into a lengthy detail about what I went through, but it was really, really bad. I couldn't perform. I was just frozen, basically. And social anxiety disorder, stuff like that. And so one day, years after the book came out, I was in my storage unit, and the door was facing west, and the sun was setting, and the sun was blaring in like crazy. I'm by myself, cleaning out the storage, organizing things, and I see this guy. He's probably this tall. Right? And I just see the silhouette of him. And he's walking towards my storage unit. And I'm thinking, oh boy, this is where I buy the farm. This is where and then it gets worse. And then I hear him say, are you Donny Osmond? And I'm thinking, yeah, this is it. This is all. And I said, yes. He said, I need to talk to you. So I walked up to him, and the closer I got to him, the more I could see his face. He's crying.
Aww.
And he proceeded to tell me that he's a football player. He's a linebacker. And just the biggest guy. He says, I've stopped football, and I'm an insurance man right now, and I can't work because of anxiety. But I read your book, and it gave me hope. And he stopped. He wiped away the tears and said, you gave me hope to continue on. So I am so glad I talked about it, even though it wasn't the cool thing to do back in those days. But the way you are, how does that help you? What's the significance of that song?
Can I just say, before I talk about that, I just want to say very quickly that I'm probably the youngest here in terms of fan years of yours. 2 years only. So I know.
How did you discover my career?
I have great admiration for all of you that have followed her for 50, 60 years. So impressive.
Don't go beyond 60, please.
So, 2 years, because it was a pandemic with Andrew Lloyd Webber's showing of the Joseph Show on television.
Yes.
Free. I watched Joseph with them when they were young, but it wasn't you, and I had no idea about you or anything like that. When I grew up,
where did you grow up?
I grew up actually in Canada.
In Canada. Okay.
Yeah, but no, the time didn't quite match with you being there. So, anyways, very short. So 2 years, and I caught on with this show, and I thought this is fantastic. When I heard you saying "Close Every Door," I'm looking forward to that again tonight.
Yeah.
It just completely drew me. I learned a bit of music myself. I'm going, that is amazing. So that really drew me to your profile, and so I began to catch up with a lot of Thank you, Cindy, for a lot of your posting.
Yeah,
I even know the name.
That's amazing.
So I've been catching up. I know they think I'm nuts. But regarding your story, I do psychology myself.
Okay.
With counseling and all. So when you talk about your anxiety piece, I feel, wow, there's so much right on. And yes, you're terribly brave with your era, that time, many years, 20 years ago, that you began to talk about it. And that's really, and people nowadays, as I talk to them, especially men, great difficulty talking about it, really difficult.
Yes.
And when they do, huge burden.
Well, it's people think, men think, it's a sign of weakness, but it's actually the opposite. It's a sign of strength.
So, a lot of strength. So, thank you for what you've done.
I appreciate you saying that. Thank you.
Wow.
Thank you.
Oh, I love
so much. The way you are.
Quite a few of the songs. She thinks I like that most. I do. Take The Way You Are is just beautiful. I know it's
about, I wrote that for my wife.
It's about your lovely
yes.
wife. I know the story. That's most of it. thank you. I love it, and you do a fantastic job. I think the fact that I've been following for 2 years, not just because of Joseph, says a lot about how truly you are talented.
Thank you.
And how you draw people not only with your light, but also your singing and fantastic dance, all of that, and just the entertainer that you are. So everybody knows that already, but I'm just saying, you're drawing fans. I'm drawing. I have two more families coming.
Okay.
Two guys.
Oh, wow. Where do I send the commission check?
they don't know you. But she's done homework. She's amazing.
Okay.
So,
okay, here's The Way You Are. And it goes like this.
A song from before is
Wait, hold
keep
on, hold
her
on,
in
hold
mind.
A second.
A song from before is Keep Her in Mind, which is my
Keep Her in Mind.
But I won't be the way any more time, so I think just one is
good. Keep Her in Mind is actually a good song. Let's do Keep Her in Mind.
Okay.
Let's do Keep Her in Mind. And then I'll do it The Way You Are. So Keep Her in Mind. I love the lyrics of this song. I wrote this in my pool house back home in Utah. Okay, it goes like
two, three.
I'm gonna keep her in my mind. Just to keep her out of my heart. Cause I don't
song you said?
I think I'm gonna take this winter off.
Oh.
Yeah.
He's gonna do what?
Take this winter off.
Okay. I think I'm gonna go home and have Christmas with my family. It was a long time, but the reason why. The reason why I committed to do Panto is because Debbie was going to come with me. We're going to have Christmas over there. Some of the kids and grandkids were going to fly over, have a very happy Christmas, as you say, over there. And Omicron decided to come over. So Debbie didn't come, the grandkids didn't come, nobody came.
Oh.
Six of us, almost 8 weeks, including rehearsals.
Wow.
By myself, 60 shows in 5 weeks. It's like, oh my goodness. But it's a good thing it was a fun show.
Yeah.
because that's what got me through it. It's just a fun show. We opened with another year. Is that another year has come and gone? That's the wrong chord. I got you.
We've got an ongoing thing.
Yes, we do. It's a good thing we have fun. You know, we do have so much fun here. Another year has come and gone. Who could have dreamed of the challenges we'd all take on? The road was hard. The road.
My mother was the one that introduced me to your music, mm-hmm. And I've been, and when I remember meeting you at your CD signing back in 2015 in Manhattan, I wanted her to come with me because this was always our thing. Like, we always had, like, the mother-daughter dates, like, to see you at, because we did see you at Westbury twice.
Okay.
You have no idea how much, like, your music meant to me because your music always soothed me because I kind of like suffer from a little bit of anxiety too, yeah. And
really, I don't know what that feels like.
I'm sorry, I'm a little shaky.
That's okay. I know what it feels like. It's horrible, isn't it?
I hate it.
Yeah, you feel like you're gonna die, but you know what? Don't resist it. Embrace it. Just embrace it. Okay. Go ahead. Go ahead. We're friends, okay? You don't need to worry about it. Because I know what it feels like.
And I was wondering if you could sing to my mother. Mm-hmm.
I thought you wanted me to sing to you.
I want that too. But, okay. But since my mother never got the chance to really see you in person until now,
yeah.
Could you sing the song Donna to her?
What's your name? I can't.
How apropos.
Exactly. All right, here's a song called Oh Donna.
Yeah.
Donna. Yeah. It's great.
Yeah. One of my favorites.
I had a girl, Donna was her name. Since she left me, I've never been the same. Cause I love my
have a pair of those. You have the Donnie socks? Oh my goodness. Oh. With holes open.
You walked outside of the Carpe Center in Wilkes-Barre, Pennsylvania.
Yes.
And I was holding this like this.
Yes.
And you walked out and I yelled, Donnie, you looked at me and you said, where in the world did you get
them? Did you find them on eBay or have you had those all?
I've had these since 1974.
Stop.
How do they smell?
That's why they're purple.
The glasses are mine and the hat's mine.
Well, that's yours. Oh, I thought that was
yours. And my birthday is this coming Monday.
Yes.
Oh. Is it really?
Yeah, 13th. Huh?
Yep.
Aww. Aww.
looking all better.
Uh-huh.
Right? I know what that's like.
My turn.
I've done it. I've done it. It's possible.
Amen.
But it is horrible. It's a horrible feeling. But you can get over it.
Yes.
Just, there's one thing I want you to think about, right? I know I'm probably embarrassing you in front of everybody, but it's the best thing that I could do is to talk about it in my book so everybody found out about
it. I read your book.
You read my book?
Oh, yes.
Do you know how hard it was to do that? Do you have any idea how hard that was to do that?
Nerve-wracking.
Live in the gray. People with our personalities, type A personalities, are called type A personalities. We live in the black and the white. Live in the gray. Don't go to extremes in your life. Just live right in the gray. Okay?
Okay.
Okay.
So cool.
Yep. Okay. Wow. Did you want a picture? Get up.
Oh.
Oh. Oh.
On Monday. What is your name?
Bev.
Bev. And it's, what's your age?
61.
It's a BEV.
Yes.
And 61? Well, happy birthday. Anyway. go for it. Go for it. Come on. We got to give Bev one.
Oh, Bev. It's your birthday. Time to celebrate. It's true, but 61 years sure is good on you. Oh, man, it's your birthday.
Happy birthday on Monday.
Yeah. Yeah.
My name's Michelle, and I brought this lovely couple here so they could have their 38th wedding anniversary.
And congratulations.
You know, 38 here, 38 here, add them together.
Yeah, okay.
I look pretty good, don't I?
You bet you do.
Sorry. It would mean the world if you could sing the Hawaiian wedding song.
Hawaiian wedding song.
Yeah, that's beautiful, yeah.
Okay, there's an older version. Let's do the older version of the wedding song.
Yeah.
Yes. Okay, here we go. No, that's the younger version. Okay, right.
This is the moment I've waited for. I can hear my heart sing. Bells will be ringing. This is the moment of sweet aloha. I will love you on the
I'd love to. You have a pen?
I got this from Julie Middleton.
Okay.
From England.
Does anybody have a Sharpie?
Anybody got a pen?
Right here.
Thank you. Thank you so sincerely. Thank you.
Thanks, Aya.
And I just wanted to throw out there, I am a sign language interpreter. And I just saw your brother, he'd be your nephew, do a little blurb, Justin, do a little blurb online. And I was so moved and just so impressed by how many people in your family sign.
Yeah.
And I just wanted
to. I'm doing very well. Okay. Where are you from? New York.
Yeah,
I love New York.
You can tell
what part of New York?
You can tell it.
What part?
Brooklyn.
Brooklyn.
All right.
Don't ever lose that accent.
No,
ever.
No.
What accent?
I'm from Smith's.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, there we go. This is my very dear friend, Kathleen, from Brooklyn. She flew in to see
you.
Yeah,
you probably don't remember me. I saw you at a concert like 15 years ago.
This is my very good friend, Dawn, and she came in all the way from Oregon to see you.
Nice to see you guys. I hope you enjoyed the show. Don't boo me off stage. Have you ever seen the show?
It.
You've never seen it?
Well, we went together 15 years ago.
No, but this show?
No.
Oh, cool. But it's not that I want to give the show away, but just to give you a little precursor of what you're about to see. It's pretty much my entire 60 years of show business in 90 minutes.
Aww, and, awesome.
There's. Does anybody know about the rap?
Yes.
You know about the rap?
Genie knows.
Yes.
So you've seen it online.
The rap.
It all began back in Utah. I was 4 years old. Started singing with my brothers, and the sun was like gold. So my folks took a leap and said, "What the hey? We gotta get these monsters out to California." And it gets faster and faster and faster. In 10 minutes.
Wow. And,
so everything that I talk about is on the screens, and it goes by so fast.
It's so much fun.
Yeah, it's fun. And then the request segment. Is another fun segment. You know about the request segment?
Yes.
So all 65 albums are on the screen. You pick any album, any song, kind of like what we're doing here, and we do it just like that. So that's another fun segment. The other day, this is kind of funny, this lady was walking out. She happened to talk to Greg Young, my producer. And she said, "That was such a cool segment. I had no idea there were that many plants in the audience." Yeah, there's a lot of plants. I should have thought it was all scripted. And all those people that I picked were plants. But it's all different. It changes every night. It's a brand new show. Yes, Cindy.
Thank you for your
integrity,
by the way. I appreciate it.
Yes.
Thank you.
Erin is from Australia, and she said to me, I convinced her to come to this today. She wasn't going to come, but she said, "I just want to get a picture with him." Would you take a picture with her?
No. No, I haven't tried it yet. It's in my dressing room. She brought me some kangaroo jerky, and I don't want to eat it because I'll start walking.
Come on, it's very hot show. Oh.
I may have asked you this, I can't remember. What part of Australia?
Sydney.
Mm-hmm. Sydney.
Yeah.
I love it down there.
Yeah.
That's beautiful. I told you I went to, what's that? Yeah, we need to definitely go there. I think I mentioned to you, Glenn's talking to me in my ears. Glenn's the wizard behind the curtain. Say hi, Glenn.
Hi.
No, listen to him. Say hi, Glenn.
Hi, everybody.
Okay.
Hi, Glenn.
He does exist. I think I mentioned to you that I went to Perth. Or did I mention it?
No, you did.
Oh, I didn't. Oh, I love it. That is beautiful. I was there when I was the entertainment. I got to tell you this story. Okay, so it was 1979, just before my first son was born. And I was the entertainment for the Miss Universe pageant. And Bob Barker, remember Bob Barker?
Yes!
Bob was the host. And so at the very end of the show, I'm singing to the five finalists. And before we go live, and they said, you're reaching probably about, they guesstimated about a billion people watch this watch the podcast around the world. So the very final competition, they have to zoom in as close as they can to the contestant's face. And the judges down there were watching the screens, and that's how they were going to judge the final competition. And I'm singing a medley to them. And the director told me before we went on the air, says, we have to zoom in close to the ladies. And so in order for us to get the shot, you got to be close to them. I said, yeah, I could do that. No problem. I don't think my wife would appreciate it. But. So I start this medley. We're live on the air. And I'm about this close to the first contestant. And that's pretty much breaking the bowl, right? Okay, so it's a little uncomfortable. But I'm singing to her. And I see out of the side of my, behind her, the stagehand in the wings saying, closer, closer. So, okay, so I go to the second lady. And I'm about this close, right? I'm saying, closer, closer. I get close. I'm about this one. Okay, go to the fourth one. I'm like this, right? And I say, closer, closer. I go to the last one, Miss Venezuela. I am like this, right? Very uncomfortable. Very uncomfortable. And I'm singing that song, Peg, by Hall & Oates. And I said, I seen your picture. And when I said picture, I spit all over her face.
And she loved it. She loved it.
She not only loved it, she became Miss Universe. So
it's the Donnie magic.
The other contestants, after the show was over and we were laughing about it, they all came up to me and says, if we're lucky enough to be here next year, will you spit on me?
Today is our 40th wedding anniversary.
Congratulations.
Wow. Congratulations. Wow.
What is your secret to a long-lasting relationship?
Well, I have kind of you.
Donnie Shore,
would you like to clarify that, sir?
Donnie Shore, 10 years or so. Okay. It seems to work, yeah.
Okay.
When he asked me to marry him, I said, okay, but under one condition.
Yeah.
That if Donnie ever shows up on my doorstep, that you know I'm going to have a hard time making a choice.
Okay. You know, what? You know what's funny is I did walk up to your doorstep. And it's the wrong home. I got the address wrong. Well, that's funny. Congratulations, you guys. Yeah. Yes, absolutely.
I don't know where you signed it.
Yeah, it's a little dark. About right there.
Fine.
Uh-oh.
Wow. Ida to the rescue. Uh-huh.
I can't believe you're going back. I know. It's wonderful.
Thank you.
I do too.
Except
you're welcome. He has a question about a show in Chicago.
I got a production question for you.
Yes.
We're Sue and I were lucky to catch you and Marie in the outskirts of Chicago.
Aurora.
Oh. You weren't feeling very well that day.
You were there? Oh,
yes. We didn't know it in the audience, but Marie came out in intermission and explained.
I had the flu. So I don't think I've ever had the flu that bad, other than when I was doing Joseph in Salt Lake. That was the worst.
Oh, no.
But it was so bad, I couldn't hardly sing. Yeah. And I said, I am not canceling this show. But as you could tell with the way I was singing, it wasn't very good. But I went out and did
it.
It was fun.
Yeah. I was having a little anxiety on that show, let me tell you.
You pulled it off.
But I did it. I pushed through it. And I did it. But
how do you be so nimble?
Yeah, how nimble does your music stage manager, your music director, your video guy have to do, because they had to readjust the show in the second half without you. So they had to kind of reconfigure the show, what was going to happen.
You have to have all kinds of contingency plans. You don't know what's going to happen. As a matter of fact, I remember a show that Marie and I were doing in Fresno. Can't think of where it was. Anyways, around that area. And it was an outdoor event. Right on the tip of my tongue.
Sandy Amphitheater.
No, it wasn't Sandy Amphitheater. Were you at that show?
Yeah.
Oh, that was hot.
It was so hot.
It was hot. But it was a fun show, though.
It was so great.
You were sweating.
I was sweating. That's for sure. Yes. When we were talking about that, yeah, we were sweating. Real bad. Real bad.
She remembers all of them.
So sweating has never stopped. during the show, and it was an outdoor amphitheater, there were all of these people up on the grass, and then of course in the seats, and somebody hit a transformer.
Ooh.
And told
hit a transformer.
We had no power at all.
Ooh.
And it was like at the beginning of the show. So Marie and I talked to each other, and I said, okay, let's do it. So I made an announcement. Ladies and gentlemen, stay right there. We'll figure something out. Hold on. I go backstage. I found the stagehand. I said, do you have a generator? He says, we have a generator down in the basement. I said, go get it now. He brings it up. I said, give me as many extension cords as you can. We had this one little Fender amplifier on stage.
Oh.
And I plugged the Fender amplifier into this generator, put at the bass guitar and a guitar,
two mics,
and our mics.
Oh my
God. No.
We got the receivers and plugged them into this little amplifier. It was big enough to handle all of it.
How big was this theater?
It was there's probably about 4,000
all
together, right? So
wow.
The drummer had to play really, really soft. We had a piano on stage, so we had some musicality. And we took flashlights and we taped them to our microphones. And we turned the flashlights on so people could see our faces. And then we got these candles and we lined the stage with candles.
Oh my God.
And we put on a show.
Wow.
And I mean, it was a show that I'll never see again. But you have to have contingency plans. We certainly did have to have a contingency plan.
Did you tell any ghost stories with that?
Yes. But just one more, then I've got to start getting ready.
Oh. Friend of this very silent woman who would never, ever, in a million years ask you for a picture. But if you could go there and you could go there, I could get a picture of
Karen.
Then
I've got to wrap this up.
Karen.
Okay.
Come on.
Well, you guys, I have got a lot of warming up to do.
I have one question.
Yes.
Not one. Just too embarrassed to ask you,
yes.
But she would love to hear you, and maybe you can do it at the show. Love me for a reason.
Give me Love Me For a Reason real fast. Because that's not in the show unless we do it at the request.
We love you for many reasons, Donnie.
Yes, are
you? So does Debbie. Be nice.
I love this song.
Don't love me for fun, girl. Let me be the one.
Absolutely.
Her name is Camille.
Let me do that in the back because I'm going to split real fast.
Real quick, I just want to let you know, the first time I met you was in 79 at Kirby Center.
Kirby Center, I remember Kirby Center.
I had an old fan club card from 74, and this was in 1989, and I covered the expiration date, and I told the guy that I was told if I showed that, I could meet you.
And you got in.
And he pushed me through the double door.
Is that the way you got in here tonight?
Yeah.
Oh, yes, I'm going to sign this. I will sign this and send it back out with her. Absolutely. Yeah, real fast. Because I got to get going.
Yeah, I'm. Happy birthday!
Yeah.
Happy birthday,
Ben! Happy birthday, Ben!
Sorry. You got it.
See, Caleb.
Okay,
sorry. I was able to share you with my kids because of.